Dewa Dasar Ali. Cinta. What do you think about cinta? What do you think about love?
No such thing.
For you. There's no such
It's
thing.
It's not real.
Okay.
It's an illusion.
Tapi kamu bilang kamu gak mau menikah ya, Sean?
Enggak,
you don't wanna get married. Was it the experience that happened in your circle, close circle? Misalnya,
ya, pasti,
your mom and dad
pasti.
Finally divorced, mempengaruhi?
Yeah, of course it's a fact.
But you said before that you're the one who told Pak Ahok untuk separate aja.
Ya, yeah, I did, karena kalau mereka udah gak cocok, ngapain berantem sampai satu stroke terus mati? For me, it's not worth it.
Hi guys, cuma di vlog aku dan hari ini I have someone totally different than usually my guest yet on my vlog. Someone that I've never met before. Have you met before?
No.
No, this is the first time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So please welcome. Ini dia anak Bapak Ahok. Sebel nggak lo?
Enggak.
Okay. Let me just repeat one more time. Please welcome on my vlog Nicola Sean,
AKA anak Bapak Ahok.
How old are you?
24 this year.
24 this year. 17 tahun berbeda dengan saya umurnya. Ahok. Pastinya dong.
What about him?
What about him? Pak Ahok itu kan kelihatannya selalu galak.
Uh-huh.
Right? Selalu kelihatannya tuh straightforward. Kamu sebagai anaknya sering marahin enggak sama dia?
Saya kelihatan galak enggak?
You are a little bit.
Ya udahlah.
Sama jadi.
Saling berantem paling.
When was the last time you berantem with your dad? Like berantem, bener-bener berantem.
That's like a month ago or like 3 weeks ago, I think.
Oh ya? Yeah?
Yeah.
You guys tuh kalau berantem, cause you're loud. Ya, ini gue baru ketemu sama Sean beberapa menit aja. I can tell that you're very loud and you're very straightforward. Okay?
Yeah.
Your dad kan juga gitu kan?
Yeah.
I think it's genetic.
I think so.
So when you guys like fighting and argue, itu bener-bener loud banget.
Yeah, no, we just talk. We just talk like my opinion, his opinion, and then we just talk. And after that, yeah, we give each other the silent treatment. After that,
oh yeah,
we just make peace and then ya udah.
Lo termasuk orang yang bisa apa mengungkapkan rasa, misalnya when you make a mistake and then you say sorry, atau susah untuk?
Kayak harus kayak tahan nafas dulu. Nanya kayak okay. I'm sorry, it's my fault, okay.
And then bisa.
Just don't talk about it anymore.
Alright. Kalau Pak Ahok tuh gimana? Orang yang gampang untuk minta maaf nggak? To you?
Dia juga agak mirip sih. Okay, yeah. He doesn't wanna be wrong ya. Yeah. Right. Kayak yeah, when he's wrong ya udah sorry dan ya udah done.
Okay. Jadi kalian berdua tuh sebenarnya hampir mirip ya.
Iya.
Okay. Ini gue udah tanyain di vlog lain tapi I have to ask karena kan penonton berbeda-beda nih.
Yeah.
Sean, how does it feel menjadi anak dari a person as big as Ahok?
In this country. I don't know what it's like to be an anak of an ordinary person.
Oh, jadi, karena dari dulu
kayak I'm with my dad, ya pasti plus and minus.
Yeah.
Yang saya tahu sih kayak my dad udah bukan kayak punya keluarga sendiri lagi, I mean kayak dia udah kayak punya masyarakat gitu.
Yeah.
Jadi kayak yang ada ya mungkin we don't have as much time, cuman then again every moment I have spent with my dad itu jadi lebih precious karena saking dikit waktunya. Jadi setiap kali ajak nonton film dulu sebelum pandemi ke 21 nonton film perang atau action itu pasti kayak I really cherish those moments dan I ingat banget my dad dulu pernah bilang kayak pas saya dulu kan sempat sering nonton sama teman dia bilang one day you know we will not have time like this to watch together.
Right.
And I ingat banget what he said.
Yeah.
Jadi kayak every time dia ada film baru dia ajak ya I watch. Jadi intinya kayak I terima aja my dad itu kayak his heart isn't just for the family tapi for like Indonesians.
Right.
Indonesian people.
Jadi itu kan okay-nya, bagusnya. Karena kan Pak Ahok juga mendapatkan banyak compliment. Misalnya saat dia memimpin juga kan pasti ada plus minusnya. Banyak orang yang juga senang sama beliau gitu. Dan pasti kan juga it impacts your life, right? Tapi enggak enaknya apa menjadi anaknya Pak Ahok?
Yang gak enaknya ya setiap kali saya melakukan kesalahan atau saya melakukan apa akan dikaitkan dengan my dad.
Right.
And in my opinion itu gak fair.
Yeah.
Karena even though I'm anak Ahok, I don't get the benefits of jadi anak pejabat. Karena my dad itu kayak orangnya bersih banget. Jadi dia gak akan kasih me proyek atau dia gak akan, kamu kan kenal ini deket sama ini, kamu bantuin dong kasus ini atau apa. Atau kamu kan ada akses ke sini, pemerintah, kamu bantuin dong. Setiap kali I mau tanya, kayak my friend ask for help ke my dad, my dad bilang, Nico, you don't ask me lah like this. What makes you think with me yang bantuin, you akan dapat that access? You akan mempersulit. You better ask from somebody else. Jangan interfere where I work. Intinya orangnya itu bersih banget.
Do you hate it sometimes that because
karena kadang-kadang dia lebih look, I can complain all I want, tapi for me kayak there's no point complaining. And then in the end of the day, hate itu kayak I'm already used to it, you know. Banyak orang bilang sekolah kedokteran tuh gampang, you know, especially doctors. They say it is so easy, just study, it's very easy. Tapi you do it's hard, okay? It's honestly it's very hard and it like hurts. Tapi why don't these doctors complain? Because they're already used to it. Mereka ada kebiasaan dengan that routine. Jadi if you say I hate it or not to be my dad's son, I don't hate it. Karena first of all, I don't know what it's like not to be his son.
Dari kecil udah lahir begitu
second, I'm used to it. Jadi I can't really hate it because I live like this. Jadi I'm very comfortable. Yang bikin me enggak comfortable itu kalau hal-hal baru. Yang I enggak kebiasaan tiba-tiba I'm not my dad's son for example. I'm somebody else atau I adopted by a new family. Itu I lebih hate that. I hate change.
Oh, you hate change. You like the pattern, the same pattern.
I like pattern yang same, yang can be measured, yang can be controlled, yang ada routine. I really like. Something change, I pusing.
Okay, but is it a burden to be Ahok's son for you?
For me, life is like a burden, you got a lot of responsibilities.
Life is a burden.
Yeah, it's a burden. It's like for everybody, they got their own burdens to carry.
Yeah, true.
But me, my burden
berat,
for me, paling... Yeah, it's not that. Udah biasa sih, banyak kayak... Nggak, buat orang yang sering nge-gym, dia pegang 50 kilo, 60 kilo, itu for them, itu it's not a burden.
Iya, karena they get used to it.
Karena mereka punya muscles, myocytes-nya udah terbiasa, udah membesar, udah hipertrofi. Tapi buat orang yang kurus, keras banget.
Nah,
how do I explain it? I udah kebiasaan as a Hoksan, I built muscles as a Hoksan. Jadi kayak every time, is it a burden? Not for me, for other people maybe, but for me, I'm used to it. I just gotta be careful, that's all. I harus hati-hati.
Super careful.
Jangan sampai kejebak apa, and then itu orang akan bermanfaatin buat serang my dad. That's what I hate the most in life.
Okay.
Every time they try to use me to attack my dad. In that case, I rather just die. So you don't have a weak chain anymore. Or I strengthen myself. Jadi you can't attack me. You gotta go over my dead body to get through my dad.
Oh yeah?
That's it.
Segitu.
Yeah, I'll defend my dad. I think his life is more precious than mine. Yeah.
Saat ini kan you're working on your things in the kedokteran, right? That which is totally different with your dad, gitu. Tapi at some point, pasti dong akan ada yang nanya, Sean, mau nggak get involved with the politics in Indonesia so you can change something that you don't like in Indonesia?
I just want to earn money, take care of my family, don't be a burden. I nggak mau terlalu many big goals lah, ambisi apa juga nggak banyak. I just want to make sure my family ada have enough food on the table and that's good enough for me.
Okay.
Kalau ada plus additional apa, it's a bonus for my family. That's it. And I can die a happy man. I nggak perlu urusin semua anak, semua everybody out here. Maksudnya mereka ada orang tua kan yang ngurusin.
So it's not your call ya? So your call is totally different with your
call.
Dad.
No, I just...
Right? Cari pada saat hari cinta. What do you think about cinta? What do you think about love?
No such thing.
For you. There's no such
it's
thing.
It's not real.
Okay.
It's an illusion.
It's an illusion.
It's something your mind made up because you gotta escape something.
Gila nih anak lo nih. Cinta dibilang ilusi sama dia?
It is.
How come? Is it based
There's only mutual benefit. There's no love.
So mutual you think in this life, there is no love. It's there is only mutual.
Okay lah, Jesus love the world. Agape love, okay lah. Right, romantic love, no.
Nah, this is the
mutual benefit. You mau love yang mana? Romantic love atau agape love atau which love? Or
last love.
Last love mah benefit lah. Would you go on a date with a grandma?
Me?
With the grandpa.
With the grandpa. Oh, ya, what for money? I have money.
Ya sudah kan. Kan enggak true lah. Boleh, the guy has good character, is very nice, but he's a grandpa. Udah dysfunction lah.
Not really my cup of tea.
Ya udah kan. Why is that? Because
some women
you don't get the benefit. Some women want that benefit, mutual benefit in the end.
Okay, how come you don't believe in love? Pasti there must be experience that happen in your life that makes you or drive you to that kind of belief.
Ya, you enggak bisa quantify it, love. You can't measure it. You can't really tell whether the person love you or not. You really don't
know. Is it that hard?
It's very hard.
Even though when they say that I love you.
Aduh, everybody. Hollywood say it all the time. Actors say it all the time. Everybody say I love you. Do they even know what the word means?
It means
sometimes they don't know, man. Maybe they can't even speak English. No English.
Someone can compromise the things that they.
For how long? For how long?
Few years.
Oh, few years. Jadi standarnya itu apa buat
bapak
love?
Gue deh.
Cuman few years, jadi kayak, okay, if I have loved someone and compromised for 5 years, it's called love.
Don't be too loud.
Kalau bukan 5 years,
ya. Miniatur lagi marah-marah dia.
Bukan loh.
Okay, so you don't believe with that kind of stuff.
No.
You only believe mutual benefit.
I get benefit, you get benefit. Fair.
Okay. Was it because the things that happen in your life makes you like trauma about the love itself?
Life kan is all about experience.
Yeah.
Pasti. Of course, if I don't have the experiences I have, I would not think like I think kan.
Was it the experience that happened in your circle, close circle? Misalnya,
mom
and dad finally divorced, mempengaruhi.
Yeah, of course, there's a factor. There's my relationship factor. There's kayak dulu when I was a kid dibully. Of course, everything.
Kamu dibully apa, Sean?
Kan anak SPA kan itu anak kaya-kaya semua.
Tapi kan I'm rich
too. I'm poor nama.
Oh, poor. Nama, not rich.
Nama, not rich nama. Beda. Poor nama. Jadi kayak maksudnya itu kan agak minder. They don't wanna hang out with the nerds. They wanna play the cool kids. Jadi dari dulu kayak, I don't go to bar, I don't go to clubs gitu when they went at their age. Karena kayak I realized kayak, they always
people
talk
change
about divorce families. Dulu pikirnya gini, kita di Indonesia jarang lah cerai. Itu cerai tuh barat.
At least jauh deh dari lu ya.
Itu hidup-hidup orang barat lah yang suka cerai, suka nikah, suka free sex. Itu mah orang barat semua.
Alright.
Itu pemikirannya gitu. And then even when I see a my friend ada yang divorce di pasti sekolah di SPH, I bilang, it won't happen to me, won't happen to me. Pas di UI juga ada yang cerai, it won't happen, happen to me. Karena tiba-tiba, it happened to me. Kan shock kan?
Iya.
Jadi kayak, I thought my family was good, I thought my family is intact. And then tiba-tiba, I lose my family support. My parents support. Tiba-tiba I gotta fight for myself.
You gotta fight
for
yourself.
I can't depend on them karena mereka the bias. I open up to my dad, dia akan talk bad about my mom. I open up to my mom, dia akan talk bad about my dad.
Karena semua orang punya side.
Jadi kayak I udah gak bisa open up to both of them together. But the best part about that is I can take benefit from both sides. Jadi kalau I lagi berantem with my dad, I deketin my mom. Berantem with my mom, deketin my dad. Ya udah. Jadi I just whatever suits me.
Jadi itu
the plus and minus. Tapi for me jadinya kayak I don't want to repeat that. I don't think any kid should endure divorce. For me,
it's hard, yes, Sean.
A thousand happy, successful marriages is too little. But one broken divorced family is too much.
Oof.
Itu the value-nya, the quantity-nya is different for me. Jadi I rather minimize the risk.
But you said before that you're the one who told Pak Ahok untuk separate aja.
Yeah, I did. Karena kalau mereka udah nggak cocok, ngapain berantem sampai satu stroke terus mati? For me, it's not worth it. I rather have both families, both parents intact, even though they're separate, dibanding they're together and then they keep fighting. And no one's gonna win karena it's a relationship, it's love. Mana ada dasar hukumnya buat love? That's why I don't believe in something like love because there's no dasar for it. How do you judge who's right or who's wrong? The divorce, whose fault is it? Both sides are wrong.
Both sides.
Dua-dua pasti ada salahnya.
Satu tenggo, right?
Exactly. Jadi kedua-duanya ada satu lebih salahnya lebih fatal dari yang lain, but they both have a mistake that trigger each other, cause and effect that cause this catastrophe, this snowball effect.
Right. How could you finally make a peace with that kind of situation? Because you said before, it took you a year to finally, you know, make a peace to both of them.
I just accept as it is, gitu. Like, the things that I can't control, I just accept. And then I know it's life, You gotta profit from your losses. You gotta make do with what you have.
Yeah,
you just can't surrender and you just can't quit. You just gotta keep moving, you know? Like, for me, there's never a suicide button. I'll never kill myself.
I will never
kill myself.
Yeah.
As low as I get, like I won't kill myself, you know?
Nangis paling ini.
Enggak sih. I mean, like, more like,
did you cry?
God, I never cry when I divorce. I don't care.
Even when you're alone?
Look, I'm alone, but I'm not lonely. There's a difference. And to be honest, I like it being alone. Yeah. I got more time in my hands. I got more control with me.
What did you do with your hand? Tidak semua a product of a broken family and always end up with a broken children.
No.
You almost graduated, hampir jadi dokter.
Yep.
It means there must be, even though your mom and dad mungkin dari kacamata dunia gagal untuk jadi couple, but there must be something
pasti
good.
Look,
yang mereka
my
lakuin.
My parents, yes, yeah, they're good. When I was young, yeah, they bring me to church. Yeah. Mereka kayak discipline me, they yeah teach me. Jujur ya, kalau mau punya anak ya, yeah, kayaknya kalau udah tua, udah remaja itu udah agak sulit.
Yeah.
Karena remaja itu masa adolescent itu agak rebellious.
Yeah.
Paling baik itu ditanam saat masih muda, masih kecil. Mm. Itu dilatih, didisiplin, yeah, jangan dimanjain.
Yeah.
Kalau berantem suruh urusin sendiri, jangan kayak aduh jangan
panggil bapak lo, panggil
bapak lo, yeah, ini keenakan buat anaknya.
Yeah.
Harus keras dikit gitu, yeah, kan. Stimulasi namanya.
True, I agree with that.
Stimulate them, yeah, so they're ready for the world. If you pamper them ya, yeah, mereka yeah kan pas mereka udah tua, mereka kan berasa bahwa mereka ekspektasinya itu ya yeah, I'm entitled.
Yeah. Yeah.
I deserve this. My yeah parents pamper me, you should pamper me too.
Yeah.
Logikanya, instingnya akan begitu. Cuma kalau lu ajarin berapa susah hidup, mereka harus berjuang sendiri. Yeah. They will have the instincts to survive even after you're gone.
Makanya kamu
karena rasa, anak yang dididik, yang didisiplin itu yeah pasti dia cinta. If you don't discipline your kid, pasti you gak cinta your kid.
Them. Right. Yeah. So you're not gonna be Sean, Nicola Sean today,
yeah,
if it's because of what your dad did, especially pasti how the way he disciplined you.
Yeah.
So you're thankful for that. Even though sometimes pernah dipukul pakai
rusak. Ya, tapi kayak udah pukul mak cowok.
Iyalah, aku juga pernah dipukul.
Cowok masa pukul, oh wow sih.
Right, right.
Enak aja.
Orang dulu tuh emang gitu. Orang dulu emang gitu. How the way they parenting
kayaknya
ya gitu.
Kan sekarang jadi
sapu lidi.
Spoil kan.
Sekarang kan nggak boleh.
Sekarang kan orang right lebih spoil.
Iya.
Karakternya tuh kayak menurun.
Jadi lebih lembek.
Karakternya kayak mau cepet-cepet aja.
Iya.
Semuanya nggak mau proses. Semuanya kayak iya langsung jadi, iya langsung
terus
jadi.
Terus when your mom and dad hit you, bukan pukulin yang sampai hancur lo begitu ya. Paling pakai sapu lidi, pakai sedikit-sedikit.
Kalau yang kasih cabe.
Iya pakai cabe. It means because they love you, they want to be the best out of you. Keluar gitu ya kan?
Iya.
Right? Oke, okay, jadi itu yang membuat kamu sampai saat ini akhirnya bisa the way you are walaupun you are unfortunately a product of a papa mama
broken,
yang berpisah.
Broken home. I always have
papa
the joke.
Mama yang berpisah.
Broken home. Tapi kayak seriously, I don't care man.
Of course.
You can say you can label me
it's
whatever you want.
It's not gonna change you. It's not
yeah
gonna change who you are.
Broken home. Lebih malu you the successful yeah the good family home tapi you rusak.
Rusak.
Emang broken home enggak rusak. Right. Lebih malu yang good family. Oh, kok tiba-tiba anaknya kayak gitu sih? What yeah happened? Gitu
sure
kan? Tapi broken home, I'm fine. I'm
right
still in school. I'm still working hard. I'm
right
still trying to make money. I'm yep not spoiled.
Yep.
I'm not flexing anywhere.
Pinter kamu. Masih kecil.
Enggak, saya otaknya pas-pasan dulu. Gayu kok tanya mi medical questions ya?
Gayu pinter.
Wah, ayo tanyain aja. Oh, medical ini apa ini? Ini dosisnya berapa ini?
Yeah,
ini
yeah
range normalnya berapa?
Dok, dok.
Jangan, don't ask me medical
kalau
questions.
Kalau zat besi kurang, dosisnya apa, dok?
Oh, itu ferritinin 3-6 gram.
Inter ferritinin ya tahu.
3-6 gram per bulan.
Yeah.
Harus elemental iron ya.
Oh, itu apa, Dok?
Ya besi elemental.
Oh.
Lu kan bisa gabungin sama sulfate. Jadi
oh
lu kalau cuma sulfate doang itu enggak terhitung misalnya 300 mg, tapi isinya ada sulfate
oh
itu kayak enggak terhitung.
Oh.
Jadi harus benar-benar besinya karena itu besi yang dibutuhkan buat sel darah merah, hemoglobin
oh
buat mengandung oksigen.
Dok, saya cek dong, Dok.
Hah?
Cek.
Saya belum dokter masalahnya. Nanti malpraktek, nanti kena lagi bokap saya kan yeah, malu.
Iya iya oke oke. I was just joking. Oke, okay, tapi kamu bilang kamu enggak mau menikah, Sean?
Enggak mau.
You don't want to get married. For someone as handsome as you are,
I'm
as smart as you are.
I never think of myself as handsome.
Iya apa?
I always hate my face. Every time I look at the mirror,
oh, yeah?
I hate my face.
Oh,
I really don't like my face.
Kenapa? You're not tan enough, you're not six packs enough.
Gimana? Dulu dari kecil kayak pas di sekolah ya I like girls, cuman they never like me back. Jadi kayak I always
bilang dong anak ahok.
That's the danger. What if they like me just because I'm Ahok son?
Coba lihat, you're not that bad. You're pretty good.
Yeah, cuman for me kayak dari kecil I
so
never
when you
like
see the mirror,
myself.
You don't
yeah,
like
yeah
it.
I try to avoid the mirror. I don't like to look. That's why I don't care about my hair. I don't care about my looks. Karena I just don't like to see my face. Like I just don't like it. Jadi kayak I don't think about it. What I don't like, I don't think about. I just erase it from my mind.
You look like your mom. But when you talk, you look like Pak Ahok.
Ya hybrid lah, masa kan ya apa sih male female
bro.
Dua kromosom kan ya 23 23
tapi
kan.
Tapi kenapa enggak mau menikah? Kenapa? Are you sure you don't want to get married?
I don't want to get married because my goal in life is not to maximize happiness, but to minimize pain. Jadi for me, if I get married, yeah, I'll be happy, I'll be joyful apa, with a lot of kids. Cuman, anything bad happens to me, everybody gets affected. Anytime I fail, everybody fails. Kalau me, let's say I fail medical school now, I fail
It's just me.
It's
just me.
Do you wanna drop me out? You wanna make me quit? Ya udah, it's just me. I don't care. I got nothing to lose. You wanna kill me today? So okay.
It's just me. Tapi bukan berarti nggak pacaran dong.
Pacaran juga nggak mau karena I orangnya itu nggak selingkuh orangnya.
Oh iya orangnya faithful ya.
Iya jadi kayak kalau pacaran tuh kayak pacaran tuh kayak udah kayak pernikahan. Pacaran tuh kayak pernikahan jujur.
Janganlah.
It's like very serious.
Oh.
Jadi kayak nggak lepas gitu. Nggak pernah selingkuh.
You hate selingkuh ya? Tadi you said.
Me ya?
Yeah.
I play girls sure.
Yeah.
But I will never touch a man's wife or a guy's girlfriend. I'll never touch those two because I respect that. I respect guys. I will never touch. As hot as they are, I will never touch.
Wow.
If you're still in a relationship, I will not touch you. I will avoid you. If you dare, then I will report to your guy. That's me.
Serem banget ya dilaporin.
That's me. You try to get close to me, I will tell your guy personally myself that you're trying to cheat on him with me.
Tapi nggak report to the police dong.
Ya ngapain? Like I say, love itu nggak ada quantifiernya.
Yeah, true.
I have my own principles.
Okay.
I will not destroy someone's marriage or relationship.
Unless it's already broken ya.
Ya, lo harus putus dulu. Oh. Intinya, kalau mau gue jadi rebound ya nggak apa-apa.
Cuma oh, you ready?
Ya, gue rebound ya nggak apa-apa. Santai. I'm single. I am free to do.
You got the advantage as well.
Yeah. Cuma kalau you're still in a relationship, I will not touch you.
What kind of girl that you like? Untuk jadi pacarnya anak Ahok tuh
tan, submissive, listen.
Submissive. Tunduk. Itu berat, dude.
Ya udah.
Submissive.
Big, you know.
Big money.
No, I don't want a guy. I don't want a smart girl and I don't want a rich girl. Pressure. You know? I want them dumb and like dependent.
Oh my god.
I like them dumb and dependent. So they listen. But
it's just in my mind.
What's the point of having a really really smart wife but they don't submit? They don't listen. They do their own thing and they don't take care of you. Better have a so-so wife yang apa? Tapi sama di kedokteran, sama.
Brandong berisik banget nih anak
Brandong. Di kedokteran juga sama. Dia bilang enggak usah pinter-pinter banget. Ingat ya. Tapi kalau terlalu pinter, tapi kalau nggak baik hati, pasien juga mau dengerin lu. Lu jelasin ke pasien, ini ya lu harus makan kayak gini, HB-nya harus segini ya, lu harus begini. Tapi lu nggak ada perasaan, lu nggak ada empati kepada pasien. Mereka aja nggak peduli, they will not listen to you. Cuman lu otaknya pas-pasan, cuman you dalam tulus hati, you really want to help the patient. You explain to the best of your abilities, mereka lebih respect itu. Lu nggak pinter-pinter banget, cuman lu bisa menenangkan pasien, bikin mereka comfortable.
Betul.
Itu udah mengobati mereka.
Betul. Kadang-kadang dokter tuh, wah kamu
jadi
udah kena ini.
Nggak usah terlalu pinter, nggak usah terlalu itu, nggak usah.
Kayak?
Yang penting attitude. Attitude
maksudnya,
itu penting.
Attitude kayak apa tuh?
Ya, submissive and listen. Baik. Cuman ya, barang-barang, you know, barang-barang listen. Cuman kayak,
masih
for
ada,
me,
masih
cowok
ada.
Harus the head. Oh. Harus follow the guy. Lo kalau gak mau follow the guy, ya find a beta guy. Find a guy yang kayak, papi ya follow you. I know kan a lot of independent girls now.
Gue diomongin bapak gue.
Yeah, a lot of independent girls now, right? You have to find a beta submissive
independent
guy.
Independent girls.
Kan ada alpha male, ada beta male.
Ada
beta female juga. Yeah. Ya udah, cocok-cocokan aja.
Right.
Terjadi apa? Alpha ketemu alpha. Ya cerai kayak keluarga gue.
Alpha.
Ya kan? Ya gue berlogika aja. Itu pakai logika.
Hey, boleh tambah hidung gue agak dikit. Thank you so much for sharing.
No worries. I hope it doesn't ruin your channel.
No.
Cuman, I hope your channel makin banyak subscribers.
Harus
ya.
Harus dong.
Biar.
What should we close? Do you have something nice? You close it.
This whole time while I was talking, have I said anything nice?
No, everything is nice.
I think
you talk to my heart
straight away. I think you
should close.
You kind of lebih manis. You close. You know, it's like you're more ripe. You know, you could close.
Thank
sweet,
you, Nicholas Sean.
You know.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, pleasure to meet
and
you
I
too.
And I learn few things.
At least you learn something.
Jadi lebih baik. istri yang apa tadi?
Bodoh, tapi nurut. Mendengar, nurut gitu. Yang pembantu yang bisa dibawa keranjang.
Oh. Banyak boleh-boleh mau apa?
Ya kan?
Maaf tadi.
Oh no, it's okay.
Sorry ya.
For me, it's just like that. Jadi if they don't wanna take care of their husband, what is their function to be a wife? Mm. Jangan be a wife lah, be girlfriend boyfriend aja.
No. That's cheers for that. Tuh. Happy life.
Happy life. Whatever I say, you jangan take it personally.
No, yeah. It's just who he
you
is.
You kayak take it or leave it. Yeah. This is my opinion. Mm-hmm. I'm not forcing you to do anything. Okay? You're free to think. You're free to you want to hate me, you want to criticize me too. That's okay. Yang penting I don't touch any of your sensitive topics.
Right. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you.
Thank you.